Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. We welcome you all to the 31st graduation ceremony at PSG Institute of Medical Sciences and Research and PSG Hospitals. A graduation ceremony is an event where the commencement speaker tells thousands of students dressed in identical caps and gowns that individuality is a key to success, said Robert Orban. This ceremony is no different. Here, in front of you, are the proud graduates who have put the best of their efforts to reach this pinnacle. This is a moment of towering inspiration, majestic, radiant, and proud. The graduation ceremony signifies an individual's transition from a student to a professional. It is not the end, but the beginning of a journey, from the confines of a classroom to the laboratory of life to act. Act in the living present, with heart within and God overhead. We welcome you all to this momentous occasion of the crowning of a student as a graduate. Families and friends, it gives us immense pleasure to welcome all those present here who have been supporting them through all their endeavors. We shall begin with Tamil Thai Vaazhthu by Mukundan, Madhumita and Harshini. Please rise from your seats.
சீரும் வதனமென திகழ்வரத கண்டமிதில் தெக்கணமும் மதி சிறந்த திராவிடமே திருநாடும் தக்க சிறு திருநுகலும் தரித்தனரும் திலகமுமே அத்திலக வாசனை போல் அனைத்துலகும் இன்பமுற எத்திசையும் புகழ் மணக்க இருந்த பெரும் தமிழகங்கே தமிழகங்கே உன் சீரிலமை திரும்பி இன்று செய்ய மறந்து வாழ்த்துதுமே வாழ்த்துதுமே வாழ்த்துதுமே
Be seated. I now request our principal, Dr. T.N. Subbarao, to welcome the august gathering.
Good morning, everyone. Respected chief guest of the occasion in absentia, Dr. Randeep Guleria, Managing Trustee of PSG Institution, Sri L. Gopalakrishnan, Heads of Institutions, PSG family members, award sponsors, heads of departments, dignitaries on and off the dais, faculty, graduates, postgraduates, parents, special invitees, students, organizers of this august ceremony, ladies and gentlemen. With immense joy and pride, I stand before you today to welcome you all to this momentous occasion, the 31st graduation ceremony of the PSG Institute of Medical Sciences and Research. This day represents the culmination of years of hard work, dedication and perseverance, and it is an honor to address you all as we celebrate your achievements. This institute began on the 30th of September 1985. This day used to be celebrated as the annual day and graduation ceremony. This year, there has been a paradigm change. 30th of September was celebrated as the foundation day and the institute honored its distinguished alumni. In September, we discussed as to who we may have to invite as our chief guest for the graduation day. Dr. Randeep Guleria's name was the very first name to be proposed and we immediately liked the nomination. PSG Hospital was this zone's largest COVID hospital in the private sector with 400 general beds and 50 intensive care beds. With more than 70,000 inpatients and over 40,000 outpatients, we were the largest service providers during the pandemic. At the national level, Dr. Randeep Guleria was one of the key persons to lead the center's response to the pandemic, and he was also played a major role in creating awareness about the various aspects of the pandemic. We were thrilled when Dr. Randeep Guleria accepted to be our chief guest. A Padma Shri awardee, Dr. B.C. Rai awardee, an ex-director of the premier institute such as AIIMS Delhi, a renowned pulmonologist of India, a personal physician to the former Prime Minister of India, and so on. What more does this function deserve? Unfortunately, a few days back, he had an emergency in his home and therefore could not make it to this function today. We are still very thankful to Dr. Guleria for wishing us, and we welcome him in absentia. I welcome Sri L. Gopalakrishnan, Managing Trustee of PSG & Sons Charities, for his kind presence. He manages and directs the institutions towards the primary goals and objectives of the PSG & Sons Charities Trust. He is the interface between the Trust Board and the various institutions run by it. We welcome you, sir. Soon after the graduates receive their certificates, it is customary to administer the oath of Hippocrates and give charge to the new graduates. I am so very thankful to Dr. Someshwaran, Associate Professor of Microbiology, and Dr. Murali, Professor of Medicine, for having accepted the request for these roles with spontaneity. I welcome you both. Dr. Lata Devi, Professor of Physiology, agreed to deliver the vote of thanks for this function. A perfectionist, she checked with all concerned to see if her speech would not miss out on anybody. I welcome you, Dr. Lata Devi. I would like to express our deepest gratitude to the faculty and staff who have guided the students through their educational journey. Your dedication, wisdom, and support have been instrumental in shaping them into the individuals they are today. Your commitment to their success is truly appreciated, and we welcome you all. To the families, guardians, and well-wishers of the postgraduates and young graduates, we thank you for your unwavering support, encouragement, and love. They reached this significant milestone with your understanding and belief in them. Your sacrifices and devotion have been the wind beneath their wings. I welcome you all. I welcome the academic awardees, sponsors of gold medals, and members of the media. Last but not the least, I am incredibly proud to welcome the graduates and postgraduates of the 31st graduation ceremony of this institute. This ceremony is as much yours as it is ours. My address will be incomplete if I do not recall at least some of the good this graduating batch has done during their journey in this institute. The batch of 2018, also known as Zeta Taurigans, will be remembered as the last batch to have followed the pre-CBME regulations. On the 27th of August 2018, they set foot in this very same auditorium, took the Hippocratic Oath, and now life has come as a full circle. They were involved in conducting the national level biochemistry quiz, Chemistry. They celebrated the dawn of 2019 at the Anugraha Home for the Differently Abled. They offered their time, love, and material assistance to the inmates. Their orchestra team had fine blend of singers like Nandita Sunil, Vaishnavi, and Shreya Atheri, instrumentalists such as Manonit, Joel, Sri Krishna, and rappers like Tarun. They were winners wherever they competed. Their batch had a fabulous group of dancers, leading them being Shruti Rekha Patnaik and Bhavna Madhu. The Zeta Taurigans were good at sports too. They had strong football players such as Tarun, Kishore, Nikit, Vigneshwaran, etc. and cricketing talents like Ashwin Ram, Manoj, who represented the college in various inter-college sports and events. The PSG's women's futsal team has always been a force to reckon with, and they have won accolades in the intercollegiate meets. The pride of this batch is their strong presence in the NCC women's wing with devout cadets such as Aditi, Sakshi, and Sanchana. The batch organized a gala cultural show called Iktara 22, and they were the first to organize the cultural events for the postgraduates in this institute. They also re-established the new PSGIMSR Quiz Club. I became closer with this batch when they became the organizing batch for all the significant events of this institute. Interacting with students like Saransh, Shweta Shenoth, Aman Jain, etc., I learned how to make the most of situations. I learned how to embrace mistakes and have fun trying to do new things and dreaming big. There were many more students, illustrious students, than what I have just named. I appreciate your unwavering commitment to your studies, co-scholastic activities, and your compassion for your classmates. I would like to make a special mention of one of our graduating students. He is Mr. Suresh Ilangovan. After a road traffic accident in his initial college days, he was in coma for 3 months, hospital for 6 months, underwent more than a dozen operations, and today he is graduating. What a proud moment. And I sincerely thank the support extended by his family, his mother in particular, and the well-wishers for this remarkable feat. So my dear parents, your children did their academics and participated in many activities covering humanities, sports, cultural, etc. We are confident they are now better prepared to engage with the world. My dear graduates and postgraduates, we are so proud of you and honored to celebrate this graduation day with you. Please accept my prayers and blessings on your graduation and for your future. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for highlighting the achievements of this batch, and your wishes will be cherished by them forever. It is a privilege to invite Sri L. Gopalakrishnan, Managing Trustee, PSU & Sons Charities Trust, to deliver the presidential address.
Good morning, everyone. Respected chief guest of the day, Dr. Randeep Guleria, who is joining us online, dignitaries on and off the dais, heads of institutions, faculty members, members of the media, proud parents, students, ladies and gentlemen, a good morning and welcome to this graduation ceremony. I'm delighted to preside over this 31st graduation ceremony of the PSC Institute of Medical Science and Research. Pilamedu, in the early parts of the 20th century, needed more opportunities for education and employment. PSC and Sons embarked on a mission called charity because it fostered a sense of community and a purpose, namely to help them, those around them. They did it uniquely by adopting a fifth brother and giving it the name PSC and Sons Charities. They decided to divide their inherited property into five shares. The four of them divided their property into five shares and set up PSC and Sons Charities as the fifth brother. Under the charities, now we have many institutions, arts and science, engineering, medical colleges, paramedical sciences, schools. We have about totally 30,000 students and about 5,000 teaching and non-teaching staff members. So it was that vision of those founders we always mention wherever we go, that we have grown to such a large institution, serving the society in many ways, especially the hospital which serves the society, where we treat patients at an affordable cost. And we also have a teaching hospital which caters to the needs of many of the patients. Seeing our graduates, postgraduates, and their families is a delightful moment for all of us here. Handing out the certificates and medals to celebrate their achievements is a pleasure for all of us. I am happy to inform you that PSC Institute of Medical Sciences and Research has been ranked consistently within the top 50 among all medical colleges as per NIRF. It was possible because of the splendid performance of our students like you and the faculty in terms of academics and research. Apart from the infrastructural and other support that is extended by the management. You will be one of the few batches of this institute whose scholastic timelines were affected by the pandemic. I appreciate your efforts to cope up with the lost academic schedules, and here you are celebrating your achievements. Congratulations to all of you. Very soon we will be fully operational in the Institute of Oncology, which is a long-felt need. We are almost ready with the hospital part of it, and the rooms are getting ready, so we will be fully operational soon. We will also expand the hostel facility and build more quarters for the teaching faculty and staff. Do consider your alma mater as your next destination for higher education. Always remember that the success of any institution depends upon the work done by its alumni. Therefore, I wish you all Godspeed. You are beginning a new chapter. Wherever you are starting a new career, preparing for your postgraduate examinations, or just passing to consider the possibilities, I wish you all the very best of luck. Believe in yourself. You have what it takes to change the world. Take care of yourself and change the world one step at a time, your way. Best wishes to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your warm address. Ladies and gentlemen, the stage is set for the most important act for the day. Yes, we are going to distribute the graduation certificates to our graduates and postgraduates. Before that, we would like to share a few words about our chief guest, Dr. Randeep Guleria. Dr. Randeep Guleria, the chief guest of today's function, could not come due to a last-minute emergency situation in his family. He has shared his message, which will be played later. Dr. Randeep Guleria, an ex-director of the All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi, currently serves as the chairman of the Institute of Internal Medicine, Respiratory and Sleep Medicine at Medanta, the MediCity Global Health Limited, Gurugram. He is credited with the establishment of India's first center for pulmonary medicine and sleep disorders at AIIMS. Dr. Guleria was awarded the prestigious Dr. B.C. Roy Award for the year 2014. In 2015, he was honored by the Government of India with Padma Shri. It is noteworthy that his father, Dr. Jagdev Singh Guleria, a cardiologist, and his brother, Dr. Sandeep Guleria, are Padma Shri awardees too. Dr. Randeep Guleria was a personal physician to Atal Bihari Vajpayee, former Prime Minister of India. He has also co-authored a bestseller book titled Till We Win, India's Fight Against the COVID-19 Pandemic. Now, may I request the distinguished dignitaries to please come to the front of the dais and distribute the certificates to our graduates. Now, I request the graduates to receive their certificates. Dr. Gayatri D. Dr. Ilavarasan U. Dr. Ajay G. Dr. Arun L.R. Dr. Nitish Kumar M. Dr. Sri Lakshmi Zubi A.R. Dr. Suresh E. Dr. Adil Mohammed Amiruddin, Dr. Aditi S. Dr. Afreen Salma B.
Dr. Aishwarya Mrinali.
Dr. Akshara D. Dr. Aman R. Jain. Dr. Anita Michael. Dr. Anita T.G. Dr. Anjana S. Dr. Annette Thomas. Dr. Arsha Yule. Dr. Arun R. Dr. Arun Prasad V. Dr. Aruna Shivram R. Dr. Ashwin C. Dr. Ashwin Ram M. Dr. Atul Chandran P. Dr. Avantika N. Dr. Aisha A. Dr. Balakrishnan M. Dr. Bhavna Madhu. Dr. Deena Mumtaj. Dr. Devika Rajagopal. Dr. Dikshita S.A. Dr. Dikshita T.E. Dr. Dilipan M.S. Dr. Fabina Sherin V. Dr. Garvin Johnson. Dr. Giri Shankar S. Dr. Gopinath K. Dr. Grishma K. Dr. Harini B. Dr. Harish S.S. Dr. Harish Gautam M. Dr. Harish Krishna S. Dr. Indu K. Dr. Aishwarya Lakshmi S. Dr. Aishwarya R. Dr. Janani N.M. Dr. Janita Eliza John. Dr. Jaswin Joseph J. Dr. Jitin Philip. Dr. Joel Sebastian Lewis. Dr. Joshika R. Dr. Jyotsna T. Kirba. Dr. Kanchana S. Dr. Kandala Snigda. Dr. Kaushik M. Dr. Keerthi Kesavan K.R. Dr. Keerthi S. Dr. Kishore P. Dr. Kishore Kumar. Dr. Korla Danushya Subramania Shashank. Dr. Krishna Priya Sridharan. Dr. Kudali N. Dr. Lishima P. Dr. Lokeshwari G. Dr. Manigandan B. Dr. Manoj P. Dr. Manonit Samuel Jacob. Dr. Manu K. Dr. Megan Priya N. Dr. Megha Prasanna Kumar. Dr. Mohammed Danish Khan. Dr. Mohsina Fatima. Dr. Mugesh Prem Kumar. Dr. Mugin Nilavan T.S. Dr. Mukesh Palaniappan R. Dr. Nandita Jodi J.B.S. Dr. Nandita Sunil. Dr. Naveen T. Dr. Naveen C. Chungat. Dr. Naveen Prasad K.J. Dr. Nikit Filu. Dr. Nila Suresh. Dr. Nishok C.A.N. Dr. Nitish Kumar K. Dr. Padmashree S. Dr. Paul Chacko Thomas. Dr. Pranav Anand. Dr. Preeta D. Dr. Pranita Ravi. Dr. Robin S. Dr. Raghavardhani K.S. Dr. Raghav B. Dr. Rahul R. Dr. Ryan Ahmed Khan. Dr. Rekha Vinaya G. Dr. Rayon Mampalli Rajan. Dr. Ritanya S. Dr. Rishi Saran R. Dr. Ritika R. Dr. Ritvik Nivas MS. Dr. Rohit Ramesh. Dr. Sachin G. Dr. Safna S. Dr. Sai Aditya G. Dr. Sakshi Kumari D. Dr. Salma Rifaya M. Dr. Sanjana V. Dr. Sandra Sarat. Dr. Sanjay Maria Jayan N. Dr. Saransh Kumar Agarwal N. Dr. Shetra Lakshmi A.A. Dr. Shivani P. Dr. Shobana S. Dr. Shreya Ateri. Dr. Shruti S. Dr. Shruti Prajapati. Dr. Shweta Shenod. Dr. Sibi Vishal S.R. Dr. Sivaranjani R. Dr. Sneha R.G. Dr. Sneha Anna Danny. Dr. Dr. Sneha Kribanand. Dr. Soumya Krishnan. Dr. Sri Lakshmi M. Dr. Sri Krishna P. Dr. Sri Krishna V. R. Dr. Shruti K. M. Dr. Shruti S. Dr. Shruti Rekha Patnaik. Dr. Subhiksha K. Dr. Subhiksha SK. Dr. Sujit S. Dr. Sujit Chandru R. Dr. Sushmita S. Dr. Swati Sri VM. Dr. Tarun George Thomas. Dr. Tarun Kumar RV. Dr. Tiran Ashogan. Dr. Uday Arasi A. Dr. Vaishnavi S. Dr. Venilavan RK. Dr. Vigneshwaran S. Dr. Vikram Sundar M. Dr. Vikram Akash S. Dr. Vishali K. Dr. Vishnuvardhan B.S. Dr. Viveka N. We will now honor our postgraduates who have completed their course successfully in the last academic year. For postgraduate degree in general medicine, Dr. Arjun Suresh. Dr. Prithvi Prashant R. Dr. Sajid Anwar. Dr. Sushmita V. For postgraduate degree in pathology, Dr. Divya Yuvashri S. Dr. Nitya R. Dr. Riveka V. For postgraduate degree in microbiology, Dr. Ashwati S. Dr. P. T. Thiruvengadam. Dr. Suja Star Padma. for postgraduate degree in pharmacology, Dr. Jagatheshwari M. For postgraduate degree in pediatrics, Dr. Arun Kumar R. Dr. Divya Manisa KR. Dr. Jayabhanu BS. Dr. Madhumita KB. Dr. Nancy Jebba Angelin M. For postgraduate degree in radio diagnosis, Dr. Akshaya E. Dr. Anand K. For postgraduate degree in anesthesiology, Dr. Nandini N. Raja Vijay Kumar S. Dr. Vignesh Kumar V. For postgraduate degree in community medicine, Dr. Bhagyalakshmi G. For postgraduate degree in respiratory medicine, Dr. Yogeshwari N. For postgraduate degree in psychiatry, Dr. Kritika V. Dr. Shailendran V. For postgraduate degree in dermatology, Dr. Panaparambal Sugathan Anish. Dr. Sivagama Sundari S. For postgraduate degree in general surgery, Dr. Ganapati Raman Nitish Dayanand. For postgraduate degree in orthopedics, Dr. Akash Khanna JR. Dr. Praveen Hariharan. For postgraduate degree in ophthalmology, Dr. Ashwata Shri A. and Dr. Uma Priya M. For postgraduate degree in obstetrics and gynecology, Dr. Gokula Priya K. Dr. Mani Ratna B. Dr. Soundarya S.R. Dr. Shri Priyanka R. Dr. Tamil Selvi R. Thank you, dignitaries. Kindly be seated. It is now time for the administration of the oath of Hippocrates to our young graduates. As early as 400 BC, Hippocrates established the ethical standards of our profession, which has been handed down in various versions through generations of physicians as a Hippocratic oath. We now have the WHO modified version of the oath of Hippocrates. We request Dr. R. Someshwaran, Associate Professor of Microbiology, to kindly administer the Hippocratic Oath to our new doctors. We request the medical graduates to rise and repeat the oath after Dr. R. Someshwaran.
Thank you, ma'am. Warm good morning and hearty congratulations to all the fresh graduates. Let us now raise our right hand to the front, and you all would be repeating the physician's pledge, that is Hippocratic oath, along with me. Is it fine? Yes. As a member of medical profession, I solemnly pledge to dedicate my life to the service of humanity, the health and well-being of my patient will be my first consideration. I will respect the autonomy and dignity of my patient. I will maintain the utmost respect for human life. I will not permit considerations of age, disease or disability, creed, ethnic origin, gender, nationality, political affiliation, race, sexual orientation, social standing, or any other factor to intervene between my duty and my patient. I will respect the secrets that are confided in me even after the patient has died. I will practice my profession with conscience and dignity and in accordance with good medical profession. I will give to my teachers, colleagues and the students the respect and gratitude that is their due. I will share my medical knowledge for the benefit of the patient and the advancement of healthcare. I will attend to my own health, well-being and abilities in order to provide care of the highest standard. I will not use my medical knowledge to violate human rights and civil liberties, even under threat. I make these promises solemnly, freely, and upon my honor. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. R. Someshwaran. Graduates, please be seated. You have been successful in achieving one of your life's important ambitions. To motivate you for the road ahead, we now request Dr. A. Murli, Professor, Department of General Medicine, to empower the new graduates.
Very good morning to all on the dais and off the dais. I feel highly privileged and feeling proud to be part of this graduation ceremony. My hearty congratulations to the recipients of degrees and awards and to your dear parents for the years of toil and support which have finally paid off. This is a landmark moment in your lives, and the years of your hard work, sincerity and commitment all have made this moment possible. You should always remember that this success is not only the result of your hard work, but also due to the sacrifices of your family and efforts of your teachers. Today, you cross the role of a student to a doctor, from a consumer to a contributor, from a user to a giver, of course, a giver of health and life. This success completes one phase of your lives. Your liberties of being a student are over, and now it is time to tighten your belts as you would be venturing into the noble profession of medicine. From now onwards, you will be having two different phases, one your professional life, other one is your personal life. Both should go parallel like a railway track. I would suggest you to give equal importance to both. Let us start from the professional life. I think you all well aware of the roles of an Indian medical graduate: a clinician, a leader, a professional communicator and a lifelong learner. I would like to add few more aspects also, a charitable person and a good decision maker. I would like to emphasize these aspects with my experiences what I have gone through. Many of you may not aware of the exemplary work done by our institute during COVID-19. It all started in December 2019 when COVID-19 pandemic started. A task force was formed by our institute under the leadership of our late Dean Dr. S. Ramalingam. The task force included administrators, specialists from different domains. To start with, we formulated our institutional guideline based on the international research and the ICMR guidelines, and we implemented in our institute. And this guideline had to be changed every week based on the new emerging evidences. For us, the day started with status report to the administrators, discussion to update the guideline, training of the faculty and workers, and troubleshooting. There were endless meetings with the government officials daily. Initially, we faced a stiff resistance from the staff members and the doctors. We had to discuss, counsel them to alleviate their fear. I can now proudly say that we have treated almost 20,000 to 30,000 COVID-19 inpatients and more than half lakh outpatients. This is probably one of the highest number in any private institution in India. The success of COVID-19 program in our institute was due to the leadership, regular updating of scientific content, communication, and the teamwork, starting from the sanitary workers, attenders, lab technicians, staff nurses, marketing team, and of course doctors. All have equally contributed. Management skills and leadership skills are never been taught in our curriculum explicitly. Should be prepared to lead a team or work as a part of team at any point of your professional career. A good doctor has to be a student for the whole life, and we need to upgrade your knowledge and skills regularly. Research and innovation are integral part of any scientific pursuit, and more so in practice of medicine. So it is needless to emphasize that you need to continue or develop an aptitude for research and innovation. So never stop learning, never stop asking questions, and never forget that medicine is an art as well as science. Charity is another important aspect. Graduating from this esteemed institute known for its charity, I request you to involve in some charity work so that you are giving something to the society and also help the underprivileged community to get a good health care. One more aspect I mentioned was the decision making. As an able communicator, you need to discuss with the family and facilitate the decision making process. Many times you would be asked to take the decision. When you are not able to decide, just close your eyes and think that what you would do if the patient is your father or mother, then you will get the correct answer. In a country like India, where we see wide disparities in the socio-economic standards, practice of medicine cannot be pure textbook science. Moreover, diseases never read textbooks. The way of management of a particular disease in a corporate hospital is not feasible in a primary care setup. So when you practice, you should keep in mind the social determinants of health and act accordingly. Another big concern is the humanities and ethics in medical practice. My sincere and heartfelt advice to you all is to never forget the humanity. If you look at the ethical practice, there is always a green zone, a gray zone, and a red zone. I suggest you to be in the green zone as much as possible. We may deviate to a gray zone at times, but come back to the green zone. But you should never ever enter into the red zone. As you receive your medical degree, your years of concentrated study and the learning are now formally transformed into a start of promising career. Opportunities will open up and you will have a number of choices. When you begin to practice medicine, you will experience some setbacks and surprises, probably a bouts of self-doubt. You will be around at times, but eventually write more often as you progress in your career. Another piece of advice, always know your limitations. When you are in doubt, don't hesitate to ask help from others. Moving on to your personal life, you should not only be a good doctor, but also be a good life partner and a caring father or mother to your kids. Prioritize your time and spend ample time with your family. There is no point in having a successful professional life with a failing personal life. With this note of advice, I wish you all success in life. be it your professional life as doctors, researchers or academicians and in your personal life. On that optimistic note, I would like to conclude and also take this opportunity to wish may all your dreams come true. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your words of experience, inspiration and encouragement. I am sure your words will forever be etched in the minds of our students. Now, I call upon Dr. V.M. Swati Shri of the 2018 batch to respond on behalf of the new graduates.
Respected Managing Trustee Shri L. Gopalakrishnan sir, Principal Dr. Subhara sir, Chief Guest Dr. Randeep Guleria sir, dignitaries on and off the dais, professors, parents, dear graduates and juniors, a very good morning. It gives me great honor to stand here and represent my cohort of 147 young men and women who today are officially recognized as doctors. Thank you all for this true privilege. Personally speaking, I was a very quiet and reserved person back in first year. The reason for who I am today is the various little influences that I have drawn from my batchmates. In one corner, we had the nerdy, bookish stereotypes and had very little in common when we all arrived first in the college, who continue to amaze me with their wealth of knowledge and the ability to wake up very early in the morning, no matter what day it was, and some are really seasoned. Also, I personally feel happy that I am also a PSC product because my mother had studied at PSCR Krishnamal and my father had studied at PSC Institute of Technology. Congratulations to 2018 batch. We all did it. Our tenure as a medical student is one which we will remember and treasure in our lifetime. The outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic could have meant an unfortunate event. It could have derailed all our dreams and aspirations and tarnished all our characters. Instead, as I'm sure that most of us feel right now, we have survived. We have turned it all around. Because we did not tremble in fear. We endured, we sacrificed, and we prayed unceasingly. And now, here we are, cherishing this milestone that we could not have achieved without the help of our dear leaders and mentors. Today is an achievement of milestone in our journey. But remember, a milestone never shows the distance that we have already travelled, but it always shows the distance that is to be travelled. People often say, it's not the destination, but the journey that counts. The road is still long, and we have just begun on the pathway of becoming a doctor, to be tough, resilient, no matter what happens, and to remember to always have each other's back. We would not have been here today had it not been the tireless efforts and dedication of all those who have made this day possible. Thank you to our dearest PSG IMSR faculty and staffs, PGs, and last but not the least, our dearest friends and families for their unconditional support in our journey and transforming our dreams into reality, transforming us from students to physicians. As I woke up today, I asked to myself how I was feeling today. Do I feel happy? Do I feel sad? Or perhaps do I feel a bit relaxed? But predominantly, I felt hopeful. Today, a batch of 147 young men and women are becoming doctors and beginning their journey. So yes, I felt hopeful. Today, our 5.5 years journey, we begin a lifetime of promise to excellence, commitment and service. It moves like this that makes our long journey worthwhile, seeing the proud faces of our parents. It moves like this that we will cherish in our minds, memories, and that will show to this world that yes, we have done it. And we all await to update our Facebook pages with today's pictures. We learn the quality of acceptance, tolerance, adaptability, and most importantly, true compassion and empathy, which I think are the most important key in becoming a doctor. Friends, the day has come, the day when we need to be true warriors in the care of patients. Let's not just be doctors, but true healers. Every thank you we receive is a permanent badge of honor. Every smile we draw from a hopeless face takes this world to a better place. From now on, we are into this system and a part of it. We must try a bit harder to make the system a better place with every step. We must be true to our profession and generate new knowledge and pass it on to the younger generation who will fill the seats which we once filled. As of today, the torch has been passed to us, and I am ever so certain that it has been placed in the right hands. I would like my friends to remember the following quote: take pride in how far you have come, have faith in how far you can go, but don't forget to enjoy the journey. Thanks to everyone for giving me this opportunity. Best wishes for all your future endeavors and a successful life. I would like to thank my father, who has always been my backbone and has always supported me. Finally, I want to end my speech by dedicating the award to my real life hero, my mother. This is a day dedicated to you, Amma. Thank you all for your support. Thank you for the support you have given to me. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Swati. We now continue with the academic awards. These certificates are given to those students who have secured the first rank in various subjects in the Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University examinations. I request Sri L. Gopalakrishnan, Managing Trustee, and other dignitaries on the dais to please come forward to distribute these prizes. We begin with the toppers of first MBBS. Mr. Prem M. Kathuria has secured the first rank in anatomy. The first rank in biochemistry is bagged by Mr. Siddharth S. The first rank in physiology and overall first in first MBBS is won by Mr. Sriram P, and he is also the awardee of the Chevalier Dr. G.K. Devarajulu Prize for the year 2023, for which he receives a cash award of ₹1,500. In second MBBS, Ms. Shreya S has secured the first rank in microbiology. Ms. Sri Dhanur Preeta A has secured the first rank in pathology. The topper in pharmacology is Ms. Shruti Varni K. The overall topper prize in second MBBS is backed by Mr. Sarvajit V. Narayan. For final MBBS Part 1, Ms. Nibiksha UKA has secured the first rank in forensic medicine. The topper in ENT is Ms. Sneha V. Ms. Varsha KL has secured first rank in ophthalmology. The first rank in community medicine and overall topper in final MBBS Part 1 goes to Ms. Jessica G. In final MBBS Part 2, the first rank in general medicine goes to Dr. Arsha UA. The first rank in general surgery is secured by Dr. Swati Shri VN. The first rank in obstetrics and gynecology is shared by Dr. Rekha Vinaya G. and Dr. Saransh Kumar Agarwal N. Dr. Saransh Kumar Agarwal N also backs the first rank in pediatrics. The overall topper in Final MBBS Part 2 is shared by Dr. Saransh Kumar Agarwal N and Dr. Shri Krishna VR. With that, we come to the end of awards for academic excellence. Ladies and gentlemen, the stage is now set for the distribution of gold medals and special awards for undergraduates. The Nandakumar Memorial Gold Medal is instituted in memory of our late student V. Nandakumar. This medal is awarded to the topper in medicine in the university exams. The medalist for 2023 is Dr. Arsha UA of the 2018 batch. The next award is given in memory of our colleague and teacher of orthopedics, Dr. Jay Kumar. It is given to the candidate who secures the first place in the competitive prize exam in orthopedics. Dr. Rekha Vinaya G of the 2018 batch will now receive the Dr. Jay Kumar Memorial Gold Medal in orthopedics. The Professor Dr. Balraman Nair Memorial Gold Medal in Pathology is awarded to Mr. Nitish Rohan R. of the 2020 batch for securing the highest mark in a competitive prize examination in Pathology. Professor V. Hemachandar Memorial Gold Medal, given in honour of the late Professor of Surgery Dr. V. Hemachandar, is awarded to Dr. Swati Sri VM of the 2018 batch for acing in surgery in the university examinations. Dr. T. Ramamurthy Award, instituted in honour of the first professor and head of the Department of Ophthalmology, is awarded to Ms. Varsha K.L. of 2019 batch for her performance during the clinical postings, attendance and marks obtained at the university examination. Leela D. Pillai Memorial Gold Medal in Radiology is awarded to Dr. Rekha Vinaya G. of the 2018 batch for securing the first place in the competitive prize exam in radiodiagnosis. Sri Brindavan Karur Radhakrishnan Memorial Gold Medal, instituted by our former principal, late Dr. K.R. Bhagyalakshmi, is awarded to Sri Dhanur Preeta A. of 2020 batch. She has secured highest mark in the university examination in pathology. Justice Ramakrishna Mudaliar Gold Medal, instituted by Dr. K. Ganapriya of Chennai, is given to the candidate securing the first place in a competitive prize examination in physiology. The winner of this gold medal is Mr. G. V. Ram Nivedan of 2021 batch. Dr. Shanti Panikkar Memorial Gold Medal, instituted by Dr. Sita Panikkar, Professor of Obstetrics and Gynecology, is given to the candidate securing the highest mark in the university examination in obstetrics and gynecology. The winner of this gold medal and a book worth ₹3,000 is shared by Dr. Saransh Kumar Agarwal and Dr. Rekha Vinaya G of the 2018 batch. Professor A. Krishnamurthy Gold Medal, instituted by Dr. P. A. Kumar, Professor of Anatomy, PhD-IMSR, is given to the candidate securing the first place in a competitive prize examination in anatomy. The winner of this gold medal is Ms. Nandini J. M. of 2021 batch. Rukmani Ammal Memorial Gold Medal, instituted by Dr. Vijaya D., Professor of Biochemistry, in memory of her late mother, is given to the candidate securing the first place in a competitive prize examination in biochemistry. The winner of this gold medal is Ms. Amrita Shree of 2021 batch. Praveen Sairam Memorial Gold Medal instituted by four students of the 2015 batch, namely Ashwant Manoharan, Dr. Shashwat, Dr. Arumoli Varman, Dr. Sendamil Chelvan K, is awarded to the student with the highest marks in clinical anatomy. The winner of this gold medal is Ms. Madhumita Balamurgan of 2021 batch. Vishwik David Memorial Scholarship instituted by Dr. Jeevamala Mercy Janaki, Professor of Ophthalmology in memory of her son, is awarded to the candidate for academic excellence in first MBBS. The winner of this scholarship is Mr. Sriram P. of 2021 batch. He will receive the gold medal and a cash award. Mr. Sarvajit V. Narayan of the 2020 batch is a recipient of Dr. Alice Kuruvilla Gold Medal instituted by Dr. Alice Kuruvilla, our former principal and head of pharmacology, for overall excellence in pharmacology including research. Dr. Shankaran Memorial Best Student Research Gold Medal instituted by Dr. Sudha Ramalingam and Mrs. Shanti G. Krishnan is awarded to Dr. Anita Michael of 2018 batch to recognize her utmost zeal for research. The first batch of PhD IMSR, the class of 1985, has instituted a research grant titled Dr. M. Thangavelu Memorial PhD IMSR First Batch Alumni Research Grant. During this ceremony, the certificate of selection is issued and the certificate of award and the medal will be issued later once a student completes the project and submits the final report. For this year, the grant selection certificate is awarded to Ms. Mritika VG of 2020 batch. Shri C. S. Krishnamurthy Memorial Gold Medal is instituted by Dr. K. Bhuvaneshwari, Professor and Head of Pharmacology, in memory of her father. This award is given to the candidate securing first place in research in medicine using animal models. The winner of this gold medal is Mr. Naveen Palaniappan N. of 2019 batch. The Sharada Memorial Annual Gold Medal instituted by Dr. Sudha Ramalingam and Mrs. Shanti G. Krishnan is awarded to the student with highest proficiency in bioethics and medical humanities. This year, the award is won by Mr. Vishnu Ram V. of 2019 batch. In addition, this year we are pleased to introduce two more gold medals. Dr. S. Ramalingam Memorial Academic Appreciation Award, instituted by the Department of Pharmacology in memory of their former colleague and Dean Dr. S. Ramalingam. This award is given to the candidate obtaining overall first place in second MBBS University examination. This year, the award is won by Mr. Sarvajit V. Narayan of the 2020 batch. The Sandeep Memorial Gold Medal instituted by Dr. K. Bhuvaneshwari is to be given to a final year NCC cadet who demonstrates exemplary leadership and selfless service. The winner of this gold medal is Dr. Deekshita S.A. of the 2018 batch. We now move on to gold medals for postgraduates. The Professor Dr. M.V. Daniel Award is given to honor a resident in orthopedics who has shown exemplary commitment to patient care. The Professor M.V. Daniel Gold Medal in Orthopedics for the year 2023 goes to Dr. Praveen Hariharan. J.S. Gold Medal instituted by Dr. J.S. Bhuvaneshwaran, Director of PhD Super Speciality Hospitals, in memory of his father, is awarded to postgraduate students for the best presentation of thesis prepared for their examinations. It is won by Dr. Arjun Suresh, postgraduate student, Department of General Medicine for the year 2023. Professor K. Kuruvilla Gold Medal instituted by Professor K. Kuruvilla is won by Dr. Kritika V. for securing the highest mark in the university examination in MD Psychiatry. Professor K.R. Shetty Memorial Gold Medal, instituted by Dr. Reena Rai in memory of her father, is awarded to Dr. R. Prithvi Prashant, postgraduate student in general medicine, for exemplary commitment to patient care. We are happy to inform that a postgraduate resident of respiratory medicine, Dr. Muthulakshmi, who passed her postgraduate university exam in 2022 with distinction, has been awarded 3 gold medals for securing highest mark in the examinations. These gold medals are Dr. K.V. Krishnaswamy Gold Medal, Dr. M. Santosham Memorial Endowment Gold Medal, and Lupin Gold Medal. We are very happy to reissue these medals on this occasion. All the postgraduates of PhD-IMSR do a clinical audit to determine if health care is being provided in line with the standards. It lets us know where the service is doing well and where improvements could be made. This year, the clinical audit day was held on 29th July 2023, and we request the award-winning postgraduates to come and collect their certificates. Dr. R. Madhivadani of the Department of Community Medicine gets the first prize. The second prize is shared by Dr. Anton Paulson, Department of Psychiatry. And Dr. M. Suchitra, Department of Microbiology. The third prize goes to Dr. S. Inia of the Department of General Surgery. It is time now to congratulate the students who have made us proud by winning many prizes beyond the campus. Winning a state level quiz is a matter of pride for the team and the institute. We are happy to announce that Mr. Danush Kumar B and Mr. Ashik Ahmed Zawed Nazir of the 2019 batch had won first place in TANSAICON 2023, a state level psychiatry UG quiz competition held at Chengalpattu Medical College. We invite Dr. Danush Kumar B and Mr. Ashik to receive their certificates.
Thank you, dignitaries.
Kindly be seated. We shall now play the message conveyed to all the graduates, postgraduates and awardees by our chief guest, Dr. Randeep Guleria.
Hello everybody. Dignitaries present today for this function, the students getting the degrees and awards today, parents and family members of the students, faculty of this institute, esteemed guests, ladies and gentlemen. At the onset, let me apologize for not being present there physically. I would have loved to come there, but because of some family issues, I am not able to be present physically there. And I'm grateful to the Institute for allowing me to give a small message to you on this occasion. Students, this is the end of an important chapter in your life, but it's also the beginning of a new journey, a journey which will be very fulfilling, but also have a lot of challenges as we move forward. But I'm happy to know that you've been trained in a very noble and great institute, which actually imbibes all the ethos of what medicine is all about. The PhD Sons and Charity started in 1926, so it's almost about 100 years old. And the 4 PhDs by the Naidu brothers actually divided the inheritance into 5, and therefore they had what was known as the fifth sibling or the fifth brother. And with that charitable amount, they have now established it into a huge center with more than 30 educational institutes. It's something which shows the vision that people had way before India became independent as in 1926. The institute, the charitable trust actually entered into the healthcare in 1961, but the PhD Institute of Medical Sciences and Research came to be recognized in September of 1985. But since then, great strides have been made by the medical institute, and now it's become a hub of clinical excellence and also an advanced tertiary healthcare center. Therefore, students, what I would like to say is that what you need to look at is what this institute really teaches you. It imbibes in you the whole issues of compassion, service, and a desire to seek knowledge and become better every day. I'd also like to take this opportunity to congratulate the parents of the students, because it is your hard work which has seen your children reach where they are today. Both the parents and the family members have really worked hard so that the children could reach this stage today, and therefore I think you owe a lot to your parents. I'd also like to really pay my respect to the faculty of the institute who have taught these students and have made them what they are today. It's important for all of you to realize that medicine is both a science and an art, and you're dealing with lives, and therefore there is something that you must keep in mind, that you have to have a commitment to what you're doing. Students, today medicine is changing very dramatically. We are living through a revolution, and it's blurring the boundaries between physical, digital, and biological spheres. We're actually living through a technological revolution, and we have AI, big data analysis, Internet of Things, sensor devices, robotics, all coming into medicine in a very big way, and this will change how we practice medicine. But as we go and have technology coming into medicine, it's important for us to remember that we don't forget the human touch. And that is something which is very, very important. Keep remembering that each of your patients, no matter how many technological diagnostic tools that you use or advancement that you make, is still a human being, and the human touch is very important. William Osler said that a good physician treats the disease, the great physician treats the patient with the disease. So remember to look at your patients as human beings, and all their issues need to be treated, not only the disease itself. As you move forward in your career, you will face a lot of challenges, there will be sacrifices to make, and there will be opportunities. So I think you should look at life as something which will give you challenges but also opportunities, and take them up as a lifelong journey of expanding your knowledge, redefining yourself, and keeping yourself updated. You are the fortunate few who have had the access to the best facilities available in the country, and therefore I think it is also your duty to really see that we have a healthy nation, and you have compassion and dedication in what you do. I again would like to say what William Osler said, that the practice of medicine is an art, not a trade, not a business. It is a calling in which your heart will be exercised equally with your head. Often the best part of your work will have nothing to do with the potions and powders. So the important part of health is being able to connect with your patient, with empathy, with communication, and I think that is what is very, very important. Finally, what I'd like to say is there are a few things that I'd like to say. First of all, keep yourself healthy. It's very important that if you go out in this world to really look after people, you don't sacrifice your own health, whether it's mental or physical, in the process. So stay healthy. And there are a few tips that I'd like to give at the very end. The first thing is, it does not matter what you have achieved or did not achieve in the past. You are now entering a new chapter, and therefore look ahead and see how best you can really take your life forward. So move ahead, forget the past. Have a passion for what you do. That is also very, very important. Love the work that you do. If you have a passion, you will always excel in what you do. Remember, life is a roller coaster. There will be ups and downs. Each down will have an up, and therefore don't lose heart. Continue to work and be passionate about what you do. You will definitely succeed in life. Also remember that medicine is constant learning. You have to continue to learn, think outside the box, interact with people who are beyond the medicine field, and be able to really find how best you can update your knowledge. There's so much available now on the internet, but it's very important to be able to understand what you need to do as far as updating yourself is concerned. And finally, you need to have a healthy mind and body, and therefore keep that in mind. No matter what you do, keep exercising, keep calm, do some meditation or yoga, you know, that will also help you. So at the very end, I'd like to congratulate you all and wish you the very best. Thank you very much. Hello everybody.
Dear sir, we are very thankful for your words of sagacity and wisdom. Now, it's time to announce the two most awaited awards, namely the Best All-Rounder Award, the GRG Memorial Gold Medal, and the Best Outgoing Graduate Award, the GV Memorial Gold Medal, that signify a memorable finale to this function. Here comes an award that is not strictly academic, an award that is not strictly extra-academic either, an award that exemplifies an all-round performance. Born and brought up in Chennai, she is the daughter of Mr. M. K. Somanathan and Mrs. V. Jayashree. Since childhood, she has always strived to balance academic and extracurricular activities. She is trained in Bharatanatyam and Carnatic music and cleared the Annamalai University Grade 7 Bharatanatyam examination. She has won academic proficiency awards at school. At PSGIMSR, she won the gold medal in anatomy, honors in pharmacology and distinctions in physiology, biochemistry, forensic medicine, pathology, ophthalmology and community medicine. She joined NCC in 2019 and cleared her B and C certificate examinations with an A grade. She was part of the student council serving as a senior under officer for the term 2022-23 and was the parade commander for the Independence Day celebrations 2022. She was part of the non-profit organization Make a Difference, where she taught physics and English to underprivileged children during COVID lockdown. She is a good singer, dancer, debater and veena player and won many awards during the college cultural events. She is also good at throwball, basketball, table tennis and futsal. She represented the institute and has won many awards. She is an avid quizzer and has won prizes in quizzes such as World Antibiotic Awareness Quiz, PSG-IMSR TB Quiz 2021 and PSG Cognizance 2022. She is thankful for her family's constant support and guidance, especially her grandmother, who has always been her pillar of support. She also acknowledges her friends, batchmates and mentors at PSG for their advice and encouragement. Not many people manage to do all the above and yet remain cheerful and full of life. Having mastered the art of multitasking, she does it all the more successfully. Ladies and gentlemen, I have a special request to the audience and to all the dignitaries. May I request you to please rise from your seats and give a standing ovation for Dr. Aditi S. as she receives the Best All-Rounder Award, the GRG Memorial Gold Medal. Audience may please be seated as we announce the GV Memorial Gold Medal. It is an award of the highest merit. If a select few got into the competition for the Best Outgoing Award, only one gets into this highest stratosphere. Instituted to commemorate the greatness of our founder trustee, Sri G. Varadaraj, who was a statesman, a parliamentarian, a strategist and a profound visionary who thought ahead of his times. So much so, to take up the challenge in accepting the opportunity offered by the then Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Dr. M.G. Ramachandran, to start a private medical college. This award signifies long and hard hours of study and commitment, an award that signifies academic excellence far above the rest. A Coimbatorean, she did her schooling at Kendriya Vidyalaya at Coimbatore, Chennai, Hyderabad and Pune, enabling her to be multilingualistic. She was a topper in her 10th and 12th board exams. Her father works as a regional manager at Cummins India Limited and mother is a homemaker. She has been trained in Carnatic music for 6 years and loves music and arts. She joined our institute in 2018. She received the Chevalier Dr. G. K. Devarajulu Award for securing the highest aggregate in first MBBS. She was also a topper in the second MBBS exams. She has obtained honours and distinction in 10 subjects in the university examinations. At PhD IMSR, she looks upon her professors as mentors who have kindled her interest in the field of medicine. She has participated in intra and intercollegiate quiz competitions. She has participated in research studies and one of her articles has been published in the Acta Cytologica, an international cytology journal of repute. She has also participated in inter-batch cultural competitions in various events and won prizes. She wishes to pursue her higher studies in the field of general surgery. Ladies and gentlemen, may I request you all to please rise from your seats and give a standing ovation to Dr. Swati Sri VM as she receives the Best Outgoing Graduate Award, the GV Memorial Gold Medal. Thank you, dignitaries and guests. Please be seated. We invite Dr. S. Lata Devi, Professor, Department of Physiology, to present the vote of thanks.
Good morning to one and all present here. Congratulations to the young graduates. Your graduation is a testament for your hard work, dedication and commitment. Best of luck for all your great accomplishments and bright future ahead. We, the PSG Institute of Medical Sciences and Research, are so proud to celebrate the 31st graduation day with the new graduates. It's a great privilege and with pleasure I stand here to deliver the vote of thanks. A special thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Randeep Guleria, Chairman of Internal Medicine, Medicity Multispeciality Hospital, Haryana, who was not able to make up for this august occasion. Sir, we have an opportunity to hear your thoughts and this will encourage us in our future events. Thanks to our beloved Managing Trustee, Sri N. Gopalakrishnan, who has given us this huge platform for all of us to excel in our career. Thank you, sir. I also express my sincere thanks and gratitude to Dr. Subba Rao, principal of this prestigious institute, for providing me an opportunity to deliver the vote of thanks. I would also like to thank Dr. Murali, Professor of Medicine, and Dr. Someshwaran, Associate Professor of Microbiology, Dr. Jagadishwar Raj, Vice Principal, Dr. Sumitra, Vice Principal, Academic Affairs, Mr. Jagannathan, Manager, Administration, dignitaries of the dais, heads of various departments, heads of other institutions, PSG family members, Master of Ceremonies, student volunteers, administration staff, especially from the principal office, academic cell and academic section, sponsors of awards, press, electricians, secretaries and attenders who were the backbone in organizing this event. I would like to thank the parents of young graduates also who have come from far and near to grace this occasion. Once again, thank you for those who toiled throughout for making the 31st graduation day a grand success.
Thank you, madam. Ladies and gentlemen, as we leave the stage as Masters of Ceremony for the 31st Graduation Ceremony 2023, we have this to say. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. In the words of Robert Frost, two roads diverged in a wood and I took the one less travelled by, and that has made all the difference. We hope your dreams take you to the corners of your smiles, to the highest of your hopes, to the windows of your opportunities, and to the most special places your heart has ever known. May I now request the audience to kindly stand up for the national anthem.
जनगण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल भंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जल पितरंगा तव शुभ नामे जाहे तव शुभ आशीष मागे ज्ञाहे दव जय दाता जनगण मंगल नायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।
I request the audience to remain standing as the dignitaries leave the hall.
Thank you.